Hi, I'm Chet Haas, an engineer on the Android team at Google. Recently at Google I.O. 2013, we gave a talk called A Moving Experience, which was about various animation techniques and capabilities of the Android platform. And a lot of these techniques centered around some of the principles of animation that early cartoon animators came up with. And I wanted to talk about a couple of those briefly today. One is anticipation, and the other is overshooting or follow through. And these techniques, along with a host of other techniques, are used to help the users, in their case, the viewers of these cartoons, very quickly understand what was going on the screen. They had very few frames to work with, sometimes 24 frames a second, or actually more like 12 frames a second, maybe even six or eight frames a second. So there wasn't a lot of time in any particular second to understand the action. And the actions would happen really quickly. And they needed the users to be locked onto the action in the cartoon constantly, because if they missed it, it was gone and they didn't have time to rewind and see what had happened. So instead, they gave as many indications and aids to the user as possible, to the viewer as possible, so that they could really clue into what was going on. But we have the same problems to some extent in user interfaces, where you really need the users to understand what's going on in your application. If many confusing things are happening, if you're replacing entire screens with entire other screens, if the workflow is really complicated as you go from activity to activity or screen to screen or view to view, then how is the user supposed to not get lost in your application? What you really want them to do is be completely locked into the flow that you imagined for your application, so that they understand that flow as well as you did when you wrote that incredibly complex UI. Well, if you can use some of the techniques that they came up with cartoons, then maybe you can help the users understand the interaction that they're having with your application as well, and help them understand and be more productive with your application at the same time. So it's sometimes a little bit of a stretch between these cartoony effects and maybe the effects that you're looking for in your application. But it is possible to sort of connect these dots and say, okay, given this technique, what they were going for, how could we actually apply that technique, if maybe not make it quite as cartoony in the business context? Anyway, let's see the actual demo. So we have a demo here called Live Button. If you click the button interacts. So there's a couple of different interesting elements to this. One is the anticipation, where when you click on the button, it gets smaller. And when you release the button, it doesn't just return to its previous state, but it overshoots that and swings back. So this is the anticipation as it presses in. And then it's the overshoot as it actually comes back, not just to its original position, it actually passed it. There's some interesting aspects to this. One is that it makes the objects feel more organic and natural. And it also makes them more engaging in general. I saw techniques specifically like this on a game console years ago. And whether the buttons were pressed in when you clicked on them or actually popped out when you clicked on them, actually that interaction didn't matter. What I noticed was that the buttons themselves were much more engaging. And this was really important in the game context, where you really want the whole experience to be more fun and engaging to begin with. And it helps the user feel like they're really interacting with the machine in the game instead of just clicking buttons in a user interface. So the way to get these effects is very simple. We'll see some more complex applications of these techniques in other demos. But in this particular application, it's very simple. I'm not actually handling click events here. All I'm doing is tracking up and down events and then making the button look differently. I'm letting the superclass actually track the clicks and the motion events, because I don't care about that. All I care about is make the button smaller and make the button larger to overshoot. So we make it smaller by grabbing a view property animator on the button. So we say click me button.animate. We set the interpolator to this decelerator, which is a decelerate interpolator that we defined above. This means that we're going to start fast when they click on it and then slow down toward the end. And it's important to start fast, because you don't want them to hit the button and then get this sluggish feeling as it accelerates into an animation. Instead, you want it to start really quickly and possibly slow down at the end. But the main element you want is actually two. You want it to start really quickly, and you want it to be a very short duration as well. So we use a decelerator here, and notice that I actually changed the duration of the view property animator to 200 instead of its default 300, because I wanted the animation to be very quick. So we set the decelerator, and then we simply scale the button. So we're going to animate that scale, make the button smaller as the user presses on it. And then when they release, we're just going to do the same thing in reverse. We're going to set scale X and scale Y, animate those back to one, except instead of just animating them back to where they started, we're going to use this overshoot interpolator that we defined above. So it'll actually animate past one and then back to sort of give that organic feeling of actually bouncing back out and then finally settling into its final position. Anticipation and overshoot or follow through. Very important elements of cartoon animation, applicable to some cases of user interfaces. If you want the interface to be more indicative to the user of actually what's happening in the flow, or simply more engaging and playful and organic. Thanks.